He was a great hero and a great criminal, all rolled up into one. He was a genius whose genius got completely out of control.
You were leaving America behind you.
Mm-hmm.
Was there not pause for thought about that?
Not a bit, not at the time. I met Mao for the first time on the day I arrived in Yan'an. I walked in the door and there he was. And I thought, it's like a picture right out of history. You have accepted a mission from U.S. imperialism to sabotage the Chinese Revolution. Every day is miserable because you're alone, but you're not really alone, because every day you're sitting there with your own potential madness sitting across from you, watching you, and you know it's either you or him.
And you were well paid?
Well, in the local terms, I was paid better than Mao.
What did they want to hear from you?
Well, you know, it was a romantically built-up figure, this American who spoke fluent Chinese, who was from the generation of Yan'an, but unlike most of that generation, actively supported the Cultural Revolution. A revolution is not like inviting guests to dinner. It can't be that civilized, that courteous, that gracious, that gentle.
And it wasn't.
It wasn't.